There is a local brewery, one of the latest places to partner with county health officials on a new initiative to promote safer drug use. Thanks for joining us at 11. I'm Tricia Mackey.
And I'm Rob Williams. Our Simone Jameson spoke with those who work at the brewery and health leaders and joins us with a closer look.
Rob, Tricia, if you go inside any of the bathrooms here at this Madtree Alcove or even their location in Oakley, you'll see small boxes that could contain as many as 100 individualized fentanyl test strips for anyone who wants one. At least 56 locations across Hamilton County are now providing these test strips, and the people behind this initiative tell me they don't see the demand slowing anytime soon.
Best thing is they're discreet. We just kind of have them in our bathrooms here at our Alcove location and then up at our taproom location in Oakley also.
Nearly five dozen businesses, including breweries like Madtree Alcove, to places like record stores and even barbershops across Hamilton County, now offering these small green packets containing up to five individualized fentanyl test strips.
No one has to know that you're grabbing it. They're there for your use. You can test in the stall if you need to. You can take them home. You can keep them for a friend that might be a user.
In general, I think it's a great idea because people who use drugs are thinking they're going to get one thing, and they want to know if something unexpected is not there or is there so they can prepare.
Hannah Schilling is the health coordinator in the harm reduction division of the Hamilton County Department of Public Health, working to provide them.
We do say to start slow and to go low. We say to wait 60 seconds after testing the substance to give an accurate result, and then you can't let the test sit for more than 10 minutes, otherwise it can give you an inaccurate result.
The partnership to provide the test strips to as many in need as possible stems from her personal experience as a former user to help those who otherwise wouldn't have the access.
I was somebody that was chronically using fentanyl. Fentanyl has been involved in over 80% of the cocaine-related deaths. Unintentional drug poisoning is the leading cause of death for individuals in Ohio, and it continues to climb.
Schilling tells us the Hamilton County Health Department has provided more than 16,000 kits in 2022, and they've provided more than 15,000 so far this year, making the mission at hand to provide safer use access more crucial than ever for these partners.
At the taproom, for example, we see them go out in masses. It's just the right thing to do. We don't really get anything out of it other than hopefully helping save one person.
We would hope that we can continue to provide this resource long past any kind of grant funding that we're currently working under. That is our goal, and we'll continue to provide these resources as much as they're needed.
And Schilling tells me they make these test kits available to their partners on a rolling basis and on request. She also tells me that the County Health Department is working with the A1 Stigma-Free Coalition to get more of these tools in the hands of minorities. Live in OTR, Simone Jameson, Fox 19 Now.
Simone, thank you.